we will be discussing a very, very important topic. Create a kind of sense in your mind that what are the key to be successful in financial markets. Because many people, despite of having a good knowledge, they commit some kind of silly mistakes which leads them towards failure. So friends, today we will be knowing the common trading mistakes which prove to be very, very costly. And friends, once you know these mistakes, before you start a career as a beginner in financial market, either it's stock market, commodity market or currency market, you know those kind of mistakes so that you don't repeat them. So it's very, very important to understand conceptually what happens, because knowledge is important. You need to have a skill to apply those knowledge to convert into money. But the more so important is you are not caught by your own emotions, where you don't follow certain systems which leads to failure. Let's now understand why it's very, very important that such silly mistakes are never committed when we are into financial market. Friends, because the failure means these are the common mistakes, friends. Very, very common mistakes I'm going to discuss today. Because once the mistake is committed, it leads to failure. And failure is what in financial market? It is something like you're driving a car and despite of having a skill to drive the car, you are well certified because you own a driving license. And if you commit a silly mistake by not following the traffic rules, what happens? You meet an accident. And similarly, what happens here, the accident here is in financial market is a severe loss. A person who is likely to make a profit in that particular trade, he ends up with a loss or an erosion of the profit which has already made. So friend, let's move ahead to start to understand the common mistakes one by one in this session. Very common in nature that the people, they trade without well-defined strategy. Friends, in order to understand how these strategies are built, we will cover all those topics step by step in Zero to Hero series. We'll impart with the knowledge to you in terms of technical analysis of the financial market. Then on the basis of technical analysis, how strategy can be formulated and risk can be managed. Financial market, we must define a strategy in a very, very definite way before we make an entry into the stock market or commodity market or currency market. And those strategies are, we must have a clear-cut value at what price we will be entering into the market. Second is, once we have entered into the market, what will be the price at which we will exit the market? Either at profit or at loss. It's very important that when you enter the market, you must know the risk management aspect of it. And that can be controlled by position sizing. We will learn how to right position size your entry into the market in Zero to Hero as we move ahead step by step in these tutorials. Chasing the market. You know, if the market is rising, there is always impatience that I have lost the opportunity. As if market is not going to open in the next day. What we have discussed, the common mistake, number one, is we should enter the market as per well-defined strategy after we have done the analysis of the market. And once we have defined, if you are not getting the price as per the strategy so defined, why should we chase the market? Let this trade go. We'll have enough opportunity in the market from time to time. So we need not to chase the market, because chasing the market is very, very dangerous. So friends, what happens? People worry become impatient that they have missed the opportunity. Market offers ample of opportunities. It's very important that we rigidly stick to the strategy what we have defined before making an entry into the market. And friends, never think that the market will never open again. Market will every day open and it will offer ample opportunities. It is the less number of trade but quality trade that is more important than simply chasing the market and losing that trade. Manage the risk properly than to manage the profit. Friends, profit is always the byproduct of proper technical analysis of the market, formulating the right kind of strategy before you make an entry into the market, rigidly adhering to the strategy that you have formulated, and then friends, managing the risk. Because once we formulate the strategy, we must know if the market goes in against my direction, at what point I will book a loss and come out of that market so that my capital is free for a better opportunity. And hence, we always calculate stop loss along with the entry price when we enter and formulate the strategy before making the entry into the market. Even by the people who have a knowledge, understanding about the stop loss, what they do, they keep the stop loss figure price in the mind. Ki whenever it will come, I'll exit the market. No friend, as a trader, it is very, very important that you put the stop loss right onto the terminal so that it gets off the moment price reaches there and you are exited out of the trade. Many a times, you know, you are caught by the emotions. If the price you have bought, considering that the price will go up, it starts coming down, and the moment it reaches to your stop loss price, there is a tendency, very common, to change that stop loss. Never think that your stop loss is not triggered. The moment you start compromising with your stop loss strategy, that means you are compromising with your risk reward ratio. We as a traders in financial market simply cannot afford to forget some of the quotes that I am going to share with you. And these are coming from a very experienced traders, and is very, very important to understand and make permanent traces in your mind so that you never forget them and you come in auto mode to implement the strategies that you have formulated after doing the analysis of the market. So friend, one such quote is, the best traders have no ego. The ego, it's market. We can only win the market by strictly following the strategies based on analytical inputs, even if there is a loss and if your stop loss is triggered. That's very important. I cannot fight with the market. I can only follow the market. And friend, the famous Warren Buffett says, the stock market is a device for transferring money from the impatient people to the patient people. So impatience is very, very important. Even friends, learning all about financial markets and its technical analysis will test your patience. How far you see each and every video in Zero to Hero tutorials without fast forwarding, without skipping. Friends, very, very important. If you don't have patience to listen to the tutorials and learn about it multiple times, how we can expect a patience to be exercised when you actually trade in the stock market? And successful stock traders do not marry with any particular stocks. They never fall in love with a particular stock. They only date with that stock as long as they are profitable. So friends, that is where you should be trend following trader. Be on the right side of the market. If the market is moving in an uptrend motion, be long. If your market is downtrending motion, be short, so that you are on the right side of the trade and don't work against the market prevailing trend. And another quote is, expect and accept the losses gracefully. Those who brood over the losses always miss the next opportunity, which more than likely will be profitable. The three known biggest enemies of a trader in financial market are his own greed, his own fear, and he is caught into the hope. So if he is caught in these emotions, what happens? He forget that his knowledge of technical analysis, he forgets that the strategies has been formulated on the basis of inputs of the technical analysis, and then he starts, you know, acting of his own and ignoring the strategy part of it. So sets he starts sitting on a hope and look towards the terminal, and they see the losses mounting. So friends, it's very, very important to understand that always book loss as per planned stop loss. If you are incurring the loss more than the stop loss, which has been arrived before you made an entry, which means you have compromised with your trading strategy that you have formulated. And friends, it's very, very important when the market is going in your favor, that is, you are making a profit. In that case, never hurry to can take you to any level. So always ride the trend and start trailing the stop loss. How these things are done, it's a matter of learning, which we will learn in Zero to Hero step by step as we move forward with various tutorials on different topics. The moment you have entered a trade and the price starts coming down, it's a very smart thinking of the people think that they are smartly thinking that if I have acquired a price and the price has come down, I should add on to the quantity so that my average acquisition price comes low. Friends, that's a killer. That normally doesn't work unless until the averaging is part of your initial strategy. There is sometimes you do a technical analysis. When you learn the technical analysis in Zero to Hero, you learn there is always a price. When price corrects and retraces, there is a demand band. And in that demand band, if you have arrived that this is the demand band, a very strong demand band on the basis of price actions, which is quite visible on the price chart. So you plan that you will keep on accumulating within this demand band. So that kind of averaging is a part of your strategy. For a trader, what happens when you add on to a quantity, you are adding on to the losing trade. So you are further adding on to the losing proposition, because one should immediately trigger off the trade, come out of that trade the moment stop loss is triggered. Some of the people in financial market, what they do is they track 52 week low value. 52 weeks means in 1 year, if the stock has made lowest price and it has corrected or fallen very well, so they don't go to the price chart of it. They simply consider it to be cheap without realizing the cheap may become cheaper in coming days. When you learn the technical analysis, you will realize this, what happens when you buy a stock which is falling, you are buying against the prevailing trend. A very famous saying is there in financial market, trend should be your friend. If you want to be successful and earn consistent profits, then trend should be your friend. Trends is very, very common in the sense that people keep on doing this mistakes in a hope that someday they will make it. And that mistake is, friends, trading on margin. When they trade on margin, what happens? It's simply not possible to have a proper risk management, because you tend to trade or rather over trade and things becomes out of control. And hence proper risk management is simply not possible if you're trading on a margin basis. Planning everything within the capital available, maybe less or more, it doesn't matter. So friends, margin is nothing but what? It's a borrowed capital from your broker. Especially people indulging into intraday trading, very important to understand. It enhances your risk many folds because you are not following the principles of proven principles of risk management, that is position sizing. And that's intraday speculation on margin without any planned strategy, without any risk management, is major aspects of failure of many people across the world. Friends, many a time it has been emphasized by many books written by the successful traders across the globe or technical analysts worldwide, trend is your friend. And this very aspect is forgotten by many people when they trade. So friend, the common mistake is we either don't evaluate the prevailing trend, we don't evaluate the phases of the market in which the market is operating as of now before we undertake that trade. Means there is a lack of analysis, and on the gut feeling we operate in the market that since market has fallen, will bounce back. It may work sometimes, but not always. So friend, it's very important to understand that taking a trade against the trend is suicidal. Even in the trend, many a times beginners who are not good at technical analysis, they tend to take a trade which is overextended. The price is overextended or overbought situation. So all these aspects we will learn step by step in Zero to Hero. So don't worry for that. I am only sharing with the common mistakes. Once even you've learned technical analysis and then how to formulate the trading strategy and apply the risk management, you must remember all these mistakes which are common in nature, which finally leads to failure. Majority of the people, what they do, they don't have a patience to learn the technical analysis of the market so that they can do their own research, their own homework before they go for execution of a trade. And friend, they work either on watching the business channels, TV channels, or they go for certain tips which they get on their messages in their mobile. Some house will call them and tell that we give a 95% accurate trading tips, 100% accurate trading tips. Friends, let me emphasize very clearly, nobody on earth can give you 100% correct tips or trading decisions. It's simply not possible. The best of the trader and the best of the technical analyst in the world is operating at 65 to 70%, their trading decisions are correct. You should perform the technical analysis, prepare yourself, do some homework before you initiate any kind of trade, friends. Always perform analysis when market is closed. The best time to perform analysis is because you have the market which is closed and the day's candle has been completed, where you have final verdict of the market of the whole day, when the candle is clearly indicating high, low open and close price of that particular day. And then you look towards the price chart, see the formations, understand the aspects of technical analysis, which we will teach you in Zero to Hero series step by step before you make an entry into the market. Very, very important to the homework in shape of performing technical analysis when market is closed. Friends, you work on trading tips. What happens? You buy tips from some so-called research houses. Their credentials are not founded. And you pay money to them and then work on their tips. Work on the tips of TV channels, because you don't have patience to learn yourself the technical analysis, which is not a rocket science. Never buy or sell on unfounded tips. And friends, stop looking at the channels. Channels, business channels are meant to know only the news aspects of it, like RBI policy or some quarterly results. To that extent, it's okay. But if you learn that some of the tips which are given by the analyst or by any person on the television business channel, go yourself to the chart and look into that. I'm not saying that all those people are giving the wrong inputs, but you understand the perspective, a horizon on which they are talking about. If you have liked this presentation, please give a thumbs up to this video. Like this video, it motivates me. Friends, do not forget to share among your friend circle, social base, and all those people to whom you know they are interested in financial market, either stock market, commodity market, or currency market, or maybe you know them as a trader, so that they also receive benefits out of these kind of tutorials. And friend, they can also become the part of your family, my family, by subscribing this channel and enabling the notification bell. So friends, if you are watching this channel and if you have not subscribed yet, please do subscribe, enable the notification bell so that you are well notified on time for upcoming uploads. Thank you very much for watching. Looking forward to meet you in the next series of Zero to Hero.